Hi, I'm Tricia, an organic gardener. I grow organically for a healthy and safe food supply, for a clean and sustainable environment, for an enjoyable and rewarding experience. Welcome to part two of our solar pump how-to video. This solar-powered pump is great for farms and gardens and easy to install. I'll show you how.
To assemble the optional pole mount kit, first remove all the pieces and lay them on the back of the solar panel. Put down a blanket or a piece of burlap to protect the panel. Use the included bolts and hardware. Attach the brackets to the back of the panel as listed in the instructions. Be sure to tighten down all the bolts with a wrench to make sure it's secure. The pole mount has an adjustable angle, which you can set by moving the bolt to a different slot.
Setting up the pump is easy and no electrical training is required. Follow the instructions on how to make a waterproof splice of the wires that go from the pump to the control box.
To splice your wires, first strip about 1/4 inch of coating off the ends of each wire. Slide one end of the metal splicing connector into the wire and crimp down firmly. Then slide the plastic tube over the wire to help seal the splice later. Slide the other wire into the other side of the metal connector and crimp this side down. Do this for both the positive and negative wires. Now we're just going to heat the plastic over the connection to make it waterproof using a heat gun, and I have on my safety goggles. If you don't have a heat gun, you can use a hairdryer or a lighter. You know it's finished when you don't see any more air bubbles inside the plastic. Now we're going to connect the electrical cable to the control box. I'm going to put the black wire where it says negative pump and the red wire where it says positive pump. And notice I've stripped the wire back about 1/4 inch. Now we're going to connect the solar panel wire harness to the control box. The wires are labeled to be connected to the plus and minus PV terminals. Use a screwdriver to tighten the terminals on the control box and hold all the wires in place. The control box needs to be protected from the elements. So if you're going to mount it inside, it's fine like this, just use these little holes. But if you're going to want to mount it outside of your shed, you can get a waterproof container, something like this, or even a Tupperware to keep it protected. As you can see, the solar pump is very easy to set up, and it will help you bring water anywhere you want it. For more information, check out our part one solar pump video and grow organic for life.